state as well as outside the stage. I am very happy to extend a very hearty welcome to all of these participants to our two-day MBA entrance coaching program organized by the Ahilya School of Management. As you know that MBA is a professional program. You know, the uniqueness of MBA program is that the program is very useful for enhancing your practical knowledge as well as for improving your personality development. But as per the regulations of the government of Kerala as well as universities in the state, a student who decides to join for MBA have to qualify entrance examination just like other professional programs. So there are three entrance examinations approved by our universities in the state. Number one is Kerala KMAT, Kerala Management Aptitude Test. This is run by Professional Entrance Examination Commissioner, Professional Examination Entrance Examination Commission, Government of Kerala, Trivandrum. Number two is CMAT. You might have heard about the CMAT. CMAT means Common Admission Test. This test is conducted by IIMs on a rotation basis. Then one more test is there, CMAT, that is Common Admission Management Aptitude Test. This test is conducted by All India Institute of Technical Education, AICTE, Council of Technical Education. Anyway, if you want to join for MBA program in any of the institutions, you are supposed to qualify the entrance examination. Now we are conducting a free coaching program for the benefit of MBA aspirants in 2 days with the help of our faculty members. And I hope that the program will be very useful for the MBA aspirants because it covers all the areas. As you know, there are four areas in the entrance examination. Number one is English language usage and reading comprehension. English language communication, reading comprehension. This is one of the areas. So one session is exclusively earmarked for discussing this English language. Similarly, quantitative aptitude. You know, quantitative deals with your aptitude in mathematics. One session is there. We allocated one session exclusively for handling quantitative aptitude. Another area is general knowledge and current affairs. General knowledge and current affairs. 2 hour session. Then one more session is data sufficiency and logical reasoning. For that session also, we have allocated 2 hours a duration session. One more thing I would like to mention is that if you attend this class very seriously, this will be useful for qualifying the competitive examinations conducted by the Union Public Service Commission as well as Public Service Commission for various posts even after completing your MBA program. So my humble request before you is, please listen very carefully from the very beginning till the completion of this program. So with these few words, I hand over the session to the first resource person, Dr. Sangeeta, and who will handle the first part of the entrance coaching, namely English language and reading comprehension. So I wish all the very best to you and wish all the success to this program. Thank you. Now over to Dr. Sangeeta. Sangeeta?
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, good morning, dear participants here. Today I'm Dr. Sangeeta, sir has introduced Shia. My session is on English language, usage and comprehension. So before that, I need your cooperation. If you have any doubt, please raise your hands in between. And you can write things in the chat box. I can see and reply to you. And while in the KMAT, it is like, especially in this English language, what I want to tell you is, you have studied from your school days and even in college days, you have studied a paper and you have been well versed. Here, what I want to suggest is, just you want to recall it, whatever you have studied. And moreover, just recalling, and you have to just make practice. So in this session, what I'm going to give you is the easy way to make it fast and how you can make it very, not by using a hard work, very smart work, how you can understand. So it's only simple thing. Already everything was with you and you know it. And what you want to do is you have to have some preparations and practice and to concentrate how to go through it. Before going into anything else, we need some type of preparations, right? So already database is with you because you carried from your first standard to till in your law semesters, you have English paper, you have studied in various forms and all. Here, what you are going to do is you are just practicing and you are going to concentrate how to get the success. So here, only thing what you are going to practice make you a perfection. And you can score this about here. So what you can really crack and you can pass it with full marks with a good numbers. So it will help you. So here your success won't come it easily. But what we can do is you can apply your strategy, your skills. Here you are going to do that one. So in MBA, it is more important to apply a strategy in your life. Understand your skills, which area you have been best. Because in KMAT, we have four sessions as commonly like English language, quantitative techniques, and GK, and you have logical reasoning. So this is an important four aspects you are having. And how we are going to, which area you are strong, there you can start your preparation. And moreover in English, I said now from LKG 2, you have learning about it and hope so. It is a hands-on experience and you want to use a simple strategy, how to do it and how to pass this session. Okay, so here I'm just starting with every session because you have carried off 8 sessions. Everywhere you have 8 sessions. What you have to do is, before that, I'll give you the tricks and tips how to make like practices. And please note it down. And if in between you have any doubt, raise your hands or just put a message. I will give you the answer. Okay. And moreover, so this session, how you have to prepare us, the language already we know, we studied from young age. And in this session, particularly about you have to work like vocabulary were there, grammar works will be there. And little bit you have to speed up in this area because you have a reading comprehension and jumbled paragraphs, jumbled words will be there. And you have a grammar, antonyms, synonyms to be focused in this area. And then you have it is very time consuming area and you have to score 15 marks in this particular session. Why I'm very particular now? So QT, next area, GK also day-to-day life, you are seeing and everything will be in the current affairs. The questions will be come on that particular area. But this is one now, when you've been kids from now, it is in your education and you have been practicing daily, you are going with that one. So I feel like you can, it is easy for you, but this pattern will give you more ideas how you can go through it. Okay, so here in the language and reading comprehension, these are all certain because last 5-6 years of thing, this is what the thing they are asking in your exams. And we gone through all the question papers, we worked out and we got the formula for it. See, before getting into anything, we had to have a structure of it. right? We should have a plan. That plan is like here you have a grammar, vocabulary, critical reasoning or parajumbles, word or sentence have a meaning, and a reading comprehension, synonyms, tense, and sometimes we have a fill in the blanks also. So in this filling the blanks will comes by synonyms or antonyms below by choosing the best answers. Okay, so this is your proper one systematic. Now coming to the question paper. Okay, so for 50 marks, what are the contents will be there? In which are the area you want to get practices? Okay, so the first one, it start with the misspelled word in the list. So usually every question papers, if you see now different type of questions, sometimes it will start with like paragraph reading will be there. Sometimes it start with direct or indirect speeches. So here this is the composition, like this is what they will ask you. So in this one, sometimes misspelled word might be for 5 questions. Sometimes it comes for 10 questions also, but this is the content of it. Okay, so you have a misspelled word you have to identify from the list, and second one is the identify the word with the same meaning. So it's all like choose the best answers. You have options are there. So everything options, everything will be there. You know, you want to let's pick out from that one. For that one, what do you want to do? At least you have to know what is the right answer. Okay, so and it is easy. That's what I said. If it is easy for you to make some practices and get some ideas, increase your skills and knowledge, which one you are good being. Just something concentrate on the time of your examination, on the time of preparation is more important before getting into that one. Next one is like different words or sentence having a same meaning in the list below that you have to identify. And next one is identify the word that has opposite meaning. Okay, synonyms, antonyms will be there, and para jumbled sentence will be there. So you have to arrange all the answers there only. Okay, so you want to understand and you have to arrange it and give the answers. And indirect and direct speeches, sometimes it was been indirect speech and you have to convert it into direct speech. And how you are going to do, the 4 answers will be there, which one is the right choice, you are going to take it. And next one is the reading following passages. You have to read the following passage. It will be 4 or 5 lines. Don't get scared. Just I'll tell you the techniques. And if you follow the technique, sure, in competitive exams or like any type of exams, you can follow this one. All the exams, this one part will be there. Okay, then directions in proper sequence, you have to arrange it in a sequence. So this 8 type of things will be there in your pattern in a KMAT exam. What you want to do is just clearly understand, clearly learn what the tactics and techniques we are telling you. Just follow it and make it a note of it and work it out after this session. That's what I want to tell you guys. Okay, so shall we move into the main area? Are you all ready? Are you all with me? Just say hi. Are you okay? Okay, thank you. Okay, so how we can see before, how we can prepare for this attempt? Every area we have certain things to attempt. How we can do it? How we can prepare for it? One, that is important. See, usually I'll tell you the common thing here. So which one is your convenient that you can attend it? Okay, so this is I'm telling a common best strategy. For that one, which one is okay for you that you can adopt it? Okay, ma'am. So here we can go. Some common, see, before the main, I said now for 5 marks or 10 marks, this misspelled words are there. So how we can identify it? See, in day-to-day life, we are saying lot of words are there. And it's like college is a A-G-E or E-G-E. So certain words hereafter, you want to very much understand, very much keen on this one. See, usually this word we'll use in talking and all, but when you are writing it, we are writing it in a different form. So that most probably will happen. So what we want to do, we have to learn certain maximum. So I have given here from alphabetical order. Like some few words, at least daily you can prepare for this one. See, absence, you can, when we write is na, S-E-N-S-C, but here is C-E, absence. So likewise, a lot. So a lot is not a one word, a lot is a word. Then argument, we usually use the E here, argument. Then like beginning, we'll write B-E-G-I-N-I-N-G. No, it is N-N-I-N-G. So when you just take your textbook, whatever you have written, you can see. This is one way that where you are having most of the words in a misspelled way. So here we have a format here to learn. Former here to learn, right? So calendar, day-to-day life, we are seeing the calendar. What you'll write? C-A-L-E-N-D-E-R. It's A-R. Right, ceiling, it's a ceiling fan or ceiling. So ceiling, what you usually do, C-E-C-I-E, C-E-I is the right. Then cemetery, right? So a colleague, we are saying, we usually say C-O-L-L-E-G-U-E, but here is E-A-G-U-E is a colleague. Then deceive, definitely. So these are quite, so best example I'll tell you, you just take your notebook that you have written, your notebook, na? Just check your notebook, there you can see that believe type of wrong thing that we have misspelled out of the way, like embarrasses, environment, right? February, even in February we will write, you just check it off. So here the misspelled word is important. You're carrying every marks in this area. So how? It's only through practice. The one way is your notebook. I said you just take your notebook where you have written all the write-ups in the classroom. Sure, you can understand where you have the problem. This is one way that you can correct yourself. Understand? So in between, before getting into the area, I will give you the tips. So please note it down. It's by practical way you have learned it. And moreover, when you are writing a letter, when you are sending an email, wherever you are having the habit of writing everywhere, please go through there. So you have notebooks, you have textbooks, you have a mail, and even you have sent it in a message. Message, we have a short form and it's not a proper way. Most probably in Manglish, right? We usually write in Manglish. So that is the way we are being very lagging with certain grammars and certain languages. So here you have no humorous. So library, even to library we have. So this one, it's one way you have to learn. You have to practice. So what you can do is, So even in independent, so what you are doing, this is one way you can, please note it down. And like necessary, this meaning. So we'll use double C and C. And neighbor, what is this? Neighbor. So we will miss the letters here and there. And occasion, noticeable. Maintenance, millennium. Okay, so likewise here I have given you A to Z. Most frequently we will misspell words are there. We never listened it also. But here in your exam, this is the first part carrying a huge mark. At least you have options are there. Not like here for an example, you will give four things like science, sincere, or like truly, four options. So here they will give you which is the word is misspelled. There is a spelling mistake will be there. So please go through this one, just read it off one time, and in bracket it is the right answer. So we'll give you the PPT or slides for your reading purpose also. You can do it up. Just think where, which. So in words also we have a different meaning that we know. But our carelessness in writing, usually this spelling mistakes will happen. So we have a confusion, like usually in the type of writing a letter, right? principal, our principal. Usually all the students will write PLE, it's PAL, principal. So what we'll write, we'll usually write PLE. So like attendance or requesting and to be said or sent, letter as sent or send. It's lot of meaning differences are there. So we have to be thoroughly and sincerely. When you write sincerely, truly is T-R-U-L-Y. You will write end of the letter, na? When you're writing letter to the head of the department or to the principal, we can see the format will be right, but when you're using, the words will be wrong. So this way, this is one way, as I told you, practicing. Easy way, right? One trick I tell you, what is, this is the strategy. So you know, because after this you need lot of time to preparation. What you can do is take all your textbooks you have written from everywhere. Surely you have the textbooks when you are sitting in the classroom and you have written everything whatever ma'am has taught in the classroom. So take the textbook and understand and round out the misspelled words where you have did this wrong. This is one way to identify your talents, your area of weakness and positive in this particular area. Hope you understand. Are you clear? Are you clear, ma? How to identify this particular area about yourself? Can I get any yes or no? How you want to follow? Engine follow cheyanam. Did you understand this? Okay. Okay, fine. So just note it in a notebook, in a piece of paper. This is the easy way to correct yourself. Okay, then. So now, if possible, can answer me. I have given 10 questions. Please note down the answers. The next slide, we will discuss the answers. First is a, in your question paper, it will be like this. First is laundry sufficient. So which is the misspelled word here? Number one, note the answer. In last, I'll discuss your answer. Let's see who is getting the high marks here. Okay, this is your model test also. Just think it out. So I will award you special gift to those who have been getting a good marks. Okay, so idana a question. It is a practice question. Fuzzes, laundry is sufficient. So check the spelling, write the answer. One, which is the misspelled word? Edana thettai tulladu. Just note it down. Okay, chendo, doing it. Okay, or resting. Done? Cheyidoma? Whether you have done it? Yes or no? Do it. Okay, very good. Okay, keep doing it. Okay. Next one, second question. Turkeys, trophies, arrival, armies. Just shraddhikya. Idu nammalu padichathana oru cheriya changes maatre avade ullu. Turkeys, trophies, rival, armies. ഇതില് ഏതാണ് മിസ്പെൽഡ് വേർഡ്? ഇപ്പൊ ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞു നമുക്ക് അറിയുന്ന സംഭവമാണ് കുറച്ച് കോൺസെൻട്രേറ്റ് ചെയ്തിട്ട് അറിയാം. Then accurate analysis dosage. So ഇത് നമ്മൾ സ്പെൽ ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ തന്നെ നമുക്ക് അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ് ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റും. And ഈ പർട്ടിക്കുലർ ഏരിയ ഇറ്റ് കംസ് ഫ്രം യുവർ പ്രാക്ടീസ്. ഇറ്റ് കംസ് ഫ്രം യുവർ പ്രാക്ടീസ് ആൻഡ് ഫ്രം യുവർ life, this type of lifetime. Then fourth one, accompaniment, plate, interviewed. So when you spelling itself, you can get the clue. Alle, this is easy to understand. Alle, right. Fifth one, privilege, excelling, eighth. Sixth one, adolescence, contemporary, ninth. 90. So which one? Seventh one, athletic, conscious, mathematics. So mathematics. നമ്മള് ചെറുപ്പം തൊട്ട് മാത്തമാറ്റിക്സ് പഠിച്ചതാണോ? കറക്റ്റ് ആണോ? Eighth one, performance, theory, received. Ninth one, leisure, familiar, professor. 10th one, undoubtedly, experienced, succeed. You identify the misspelled word. So how many of you have done it more? Just raise your hands. I'll go to the answers. Okay, Naveen. Yes, Abhijit. Yes, Jasira. Fine. Next. So if you have done it, if you cope up with me, Anushree, Sharangi, good, good, very good. Abhishek is very good. Atul has not done. Anu Krishna, very good. See, is it easy to follow you, ma? This is easy to follow. If you cross-check the answers, you will get more confidence, right? You are doing and you get more confidence. Only few of you have done. Alisha, Jasira, okay. Devika, very good. Yes. Petra Bere Chain Ulu. Archana, very good. Okay. See, we really made lot of strategies. So one thing is what we made is it is easy for you to understand and easy for you to crack this exam. That is what our aim. That's what we all worked it out. Okay, done. Okay. Shall we go to the answers? And you have to give me a right answers, ma'am. Pakka answers. I believe you. You have to tell me, yes, ma'am, for this 10, I got this much. Okay. Okay. Let me see the answers. So, what is the first answer? First answer is laundries, is the misspelled word. Second one, none was there. Then the third one, acreage is the third one answer. And fourth one is accompaniment, none. Sixth one is 90, N-I-N-E-T-Y. You know, mathematics, E was left there. Performance, professor, undoubtedly, this is the answer. How many of you got right answers? What is your number? So just put your number, 7, very good. Oh. Full marks, you got it. Very good, very good. Oh, most of you got it. But I feel like that none you didn't check, right? In none, another. Oh, Jasira, you got 9. Fantastic. Okay, very good, very good. Awesome. Okay. Oh, Betty Prasad, yes, ma'am. Archana, 6. Okay. Might be you missed within none, right? Apo, sometimes it will be like this in your options. 5 options, none of the above will be there. Apo already 4 answers right aana, namula none of the above eldanam. Okay, missed with none. Ah, yes, that's what I said. Okay, ma'am, fine. So I'll tell you some common rules. Ippa namukku endanu aranju. These common rules, it will help you write how you can manage this one. So before, there is a rule and example and exceptions njan ivide koduthittunde. Just sraddhicha madhi. ഏതിന്റെ മുമ്പ് ഇറ്റ് ക്യാൻ ബി എ വേർഡ് ഓർ ബി എ സെന്റൻസ് അപ്പൊ ഇതിന്റെ മുമ്പ് എന്ത് വരും ഏതാണ് ഇത് അറിഞ്ഞിരിക്കുന്നത് നല്ലതാണ് ബേസിക് ആയിട്ട് സോ ഐ ഫീൽ ലൈക്ക് ടു ഗിവ് യു സം ഒരു ആഡ് ബാക്സ് ഒരു കുറച്ചുകൂടി ഒരു പേഴ്സ് വെൽ ഐ വോണ്ട് ടു ആഡ് യു ദിസ് വൺ ഓക്കെ സോ ദർ ഇസ് എ റൂൾ ദറ്റ് ഇസ് ഐ ബിഫോർ ഇ അപ്പൊ നമുക്ക് ഐ ബിഫോർ ഇ സോ ഇൻ ദിസ് റൂൾ വാട്ട് ആർ ദ എക്സാമ്പിൾസ് യു ക്യാൻ സീ ഹിയർ ബിലീഫ് ചീഫ് ഫ്രണ്ട് ഫീൽഡ് So wherever you have an I, it follows a E, files, knees, right? So here some exceptions, ether, foreign, hate, lay, short. Appo I varumbo E varum. Ini nammal believe, ezhudumbo correct ay ezhudan pattum. Mansilayo, right? Believe ingane. Appo E de munpu namukku I varum. Idu oru rule aanu. Chela exceptions la maatram evada varum? Foreign, height, lay, short. ഇവിടെ വരുമ്പോ ദെൻ റൂൾ നമ്പർ 2 നിങ്ങൾക്ക് വേണമെങ്കിൽ സ്ക്രീൻഷോട്ട് എടുത്ത് വെക്കാം അല്ലെങ്കിൽ നോട്ട് ചെയ്ത് വെക്കാം ഫോർ യുവർ ഫ്യൂച്ചർ റെഫറൻസ് റൈറ്റ് ദെൻ റൂൾ നമ്പർ 2 there is dash except after C എന്തുണ്ടാവും C നപ്പുറം so except you can expect example receive C R E you can expect. Sealing, so you can see like accepting, you can accept. So some exceptions are there, like consigns, financier, financier, E-I-E-R, some exceptions. Signs, S-E-I, seek up I wear another, specious, right? So this is two rule. Third one, does end in long, a word like neighbor and wait. Examples, eight, E-I, it's a eight. Paint, there, wait. So somewhere there is a long verse and it has to be in the long word of A. Eight, eight, faint, there. So you can't, we feel like it is A, but it is there, air, there, vain. It's E Simpsons, it comes as A, vain, right? Then, in short vowels, you have these vowels and the at end a single consonant and double consonant before adding a suffix that begin with the vowel. Beginning, A E I O is the vowel. So before that, beginning, mocked, runner, sitting, or submitting. So in exceptions like boxing, boxing, buses. So yes, one is it is to be buses also be acceptable. Then circuses, taxes, it's all be acceptable. Then there is no doubling if the syllables end in two consonants, the last syllable is not an accented. For example, short vowel. So like asking, curling, focused, opening, seated, waiter. Right? Then that to be a simple word or syllables that end in a silent of E. Silent of E, but before adding a suffix that begin with the vowel A. Achieving, achieving, E, achieving. Banking, exciting, exciting, writing, surprising. Okay, then like if you start, doesn't start with the verbal, keep the silent of E. Achievement, achievement, lately, lately. E was there to be very silent. So likewise, I have given some rules for keep the final Y when it preceded by a vowel. Keys, keys, monkeys, place, right? Y was very silent when it preceded with the vowels. It's all you studied, but for the recollection, recollecting, I'm just putting this in your exam point of time for your practicing. Like when something like add S to words ending in S, Ash, X or Z, classes, dishes, couches, quizzes, taxes. So here some of the exceptions are there. So there is a rule, example and exceptions to follow. Okay, so you all studied in your 8th standard, 10th standard, even in 12th standard. But just to recall it, we have been now in a degree final year, almost we have forgot everything. So just to brush up this one as well. Okay, so later on you can just go through it when you're having a full-time preparations. So these are all some examples. The whole world can change by a plural form. Children, feet, geese, mice, women. We won't say women's. No, it's women. It's in a plural form. Then some words have the same spelling for singular and plural forms. Deer, fish. Not fishes, it's fish, sheep. Okay, then likewise. So I have given this added. So now this one area, how you want to prepare, what is the preparation you want to do, and what is the skill area you want to identify, and how you want to practice it. So are you clear with this area? We'll go to the next one. So this is the way you want to prepare. What do you want to write is, what is the skill you are having? And what is the wrong you have done when you are writing the misspelled word? In which way that you want to prepare for yourself? That is most important. If you know that only, you can prepare yourself. You know about your plus and minus. How much you are strong in this area will be identified. Okay. So we will move to the next one. This is about the synonyms and antonyms. So in your question paper, there is a two sections for carrying 5-5 marks. Okay, so sometimes it will comes for 10 marks. Sometimes in synonyms 10 marks, antonyms 10 marks, you will get for 10 marks. The second important thing. See, in this particular area, what I want to tell you is, so you know, synonyms are the similar word with the same or similar meaning. So antonyms can be used to demonstrate contrast between two things and prove clues as they what it means. Okay, some antonym examples. Please just go through it. Achieve. What is the meaning of achieve? Is fail or like antonyms examples I am giving you. It's a giant. It's a draft. Random or specific. Afraid. He very afraid. He is very confident. He is gloomy. He is cheerful. Is very rigid, very rigid. It's an antonyms example. Rigid, no? Flexible. So ancient, they are all been very ancient. They have been very old. Now traditional or modern. It is individual and group. It's shape, corner, array, opposite. That depart. Innocent. Innocent. He's innocent, but he's a guilty. He's very arrogant. He is very humble. He is very knowledgeable. He is very ignorant. He is a single or married. Like liquid, solid, attack, defend. It's very sunny. Today it's very cloudy. Yesterday the climate was very sunny, right? And it is a very blunt. And now it is very sharp. It's marvelous, right? We say marvelous, then say terrible. Okay, then timid, it's very bold, brave. So he's a brave man. Sometimes say he's a cowardly, he's a coward, right? Noisy, so much of noisy. Then it's to be very quiet. Towards, towarding, away. Cautious, he was very cautious while crossing the railway track. Carelessly, he crossed very carelessly, so he met an accident. Partial. Complete, take a partial of a pizza or complete the, take the complete of the pizza. Tragic, comic, it's very tragic story, it's very comic one. And complex, it's very complex to solution, get a solution for this problem. It's easily, simply, very complex and it is very simple to identify it. So passive, active. So it is the most commonly words are there. Sometimes it will be the same word will come to in your question paper. So that purpose I have pasted here for your practicing. You have to get practice. I said na, practice makes you perfection. And see one way how it will help you now when you start speaking by this way, by using the right way, not by general way, so your language style will change, right? So your language style will change, and sure it will be when you're talking to people, they will feel you're something different. It will attract by others. So one way when you're writing, this is all your writing, when you do in the time of practicing it, sure I'll tell you, you will be stand alone in the crowd. Okay, when you're attending an interview or when you're talking to people, when you use certain words, get into practice. Sure, right? That's what this IELTS or been training for students. But when you start by this one, sure, I'll tell you, you will stand alone in a crowd. You'll be easily identified. When you're talking to people, sure, the senior people will understand, yeah, this guy is awesome. Something was there, right? Right. So here, these are the powerful, weak, upset, relaxed, price, criticism, urge, deter, drunk, sober, private, public. It's very vacant and occupied. So we'll ask whether the toilet is vacant. No, it is occupied. We cannot say no, it is filled, right? It is occupied. So when you are going to using a restroom, we'll ask whether it is vacant, we say no, it's occupied. Please, you can, it is vacant now, you can use, or it is occupied, you can't use. right? So such a way, just a single change can give a dramatic output is more important, right? Then vague, definite. I'm very vague about it. I don't know any about it. But definite. It is definite. It is good. Phrase, boil, professional, amateur, villain or a hero. So here of some synonyms. See, antonyms, it's opposite word. Synonym is about the same type of examples. See, either a little bit you have to refer with your dictionaries. It's more important to practice with the dictionary. See, I'll tell you, daily, you have all have the dictionary now, right? So you have a online dictionary or we have Oxford or any type of dictionaries in our home. What you want to do is daily, at least 10 days a word, 10 word a day, 10 word per day. Take 10, just shuffle your dictionary, turn some pages, right? And though note down 10 of the new words, learn it. What is the meaning? What is of it? See, our human brain is a very mass storage, and whatever you are seeing it, whatever you are learning it, it will be there in your database. So when it comes in the question paper, it will be easy for you to recognize. See, usually when in a train travel or in any way, we'll feel like we have such feeling where it all comes from, because that person, you have seen it somewhere else and he was stored in your database, and once when he comes na, the pattern will recognize him. Anganeyana nammal we feel ah evade vachi kandittundallo. So what do you want to see? Nammal aadyam adu kaananam, adu read cheyanam, that you have to feed it in your storage feed edal mathre namke exam samayath avada veru. It is a miracle of our brain also, right? Anganeyana adu valli oru shakti undu. What we have to do, you have to read properly, you have to do some practice, adu cheyumbo it is easy for you to recognize. Appo why I'm giving the synonyms examples, you have to recognize it, okay? So here appo antonym is, you can see the opposite way word, it can comes under give the opposite meaning, it will be come directly. Here give the real what is right, the meaning of it. I'm going to direct it, they will ask you, but this is the synonyms and antonyms for us. So you, I have given for practicing you, like polite, courteous, cordial, gracious. Polite ni itrayum word undu. Appo when you are using something, you can use this one. So like hungry, I'm empty, I'm ravenous, starved, I was starving like anything. When you're saying a word like hungry directly, it follows certain meaning on there. You can use any other words to risk there. Risky, they'll say it is very dangerous. It's very dangerous. It is perilous. Treacherous. So usually, it's brave, like risky, we'll tell and move it off. What the English people or others, they will use the other words. That's what we are feeling. Ayo, English is a very tough language to learn. No, the way what we are learning, what you are understanding is important. Namale, what we do now, we just simply words we will select, we'll talk and go. But if you go just into the other word, see, for the intelligent, always is a very intelligent boy, he's a brilliant. Very, very few time he'll ask, he's very clever. Clever means also intelligent, right? He is very smart. What the word will use? Smart. Nammle smart evada use cheyyum, nalla dress aidu vanna nalla oru full nalla makeup and oh, he is looking very smart. But here the answer is, he was very brilliant, right? And cunning, he was very keen on it. He is very sharp. He sharp nu varu is very cunning ana sharp parayunnathu, okay? And slicky, he is very slicky. So we never use such a word. Okay, so likewise, we have a lot of words are there. Benefit, profit, revenue, yield. We never use the word yield. What is the benefit you are getting over it? God, we are yielding it. Nothing. Right? So portion, it's a piece, a part, or a segment. It's a portion. Portion varana nammal endeyum edho or veetla or portion aanu. அதையும் நம்மளும் மனசிலாக்கும். பட் ரைட் ஆன்சர் இஸ் அபவுட் அ பீஸ் ஆர் அ பார்ட் ஆர் அ செக்மெண்ட். of a place. Okay, so likewise, so this is some of the examples I have given you, like loyal, faithful, ardent, devoted. Namala devoted nu varna we'll go in the divine line. No, it is very loyal to them. Vacant, empty, deserted, uninhabited. ഇതൊക്കെ ഇതിന്റെ പേരാണ്. ഓൾഡറിൽ നമ്മൾ എന്തെങ്കിലും ഓൾഡ് പീപ്പിൾ വിൽ സേ ഓൾഡ് പീപ്പിൾ ദാറ്റ് വാട്ട് ഓർ സീനിയർ സിറ്റിസൺ. നോ വി ഹാവ് എൽഡർലി, ഏജ്ഡ്, സീനിയർ. സ്റ്റിൽ ഓക്കേ, ദെൻ ലൈക്ക് ഓർഗനൈസേഷൻ, ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് എൻ അസോസിയേഷൻ, ഇൻസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂഷൻ, മാനേജ്മെന്റ്. എനോർമസ്, എനോർമസ്. ദാറ്റ് എനോർമസ് വി യൂസ് ലെസ്, റൈറ്റ്? നമ്മൾ എന്താ പറയും, ഹ്യൂജ്, ജൈജാന്റിക്, ഷിപ്, massive. This is enormous. So wet, when it's dry and it's wet, we say damp, moist, soggy. So idakka adinde verbs aanu. Okay, partner, associate, colleague, companion. Eng, we are saying budding, prudling, tender fruit. So idu pole namukku kore answers undu. Okay, so let's see. Ipo nammal korchu practice cheydu. I see, let anyone can answer. Find the meaning in the given list below. A lot, a lot. Engala questions ingane aayirikkuma appo a lot, a lot ana adin endana idile ulla correct answer. It is energetic, observant, intelligent, watchful. What is this answer? A lot nu what is the meaning? Energetic ano, observant ആണോ, observant ആണോ, intelligent ആണോ? നമ്മൾ ഇപ്പൊ നോക്കി intelligent എന്തിന് പറയുന്നു? Intelligent, where we are saying about light, intelligent, brilliant, clever, smart, അത് വന്നാല് intelligent. അപ്പൊ അതല്ല, watchful ആണോ? What is this alert? Any answers are there? D, okay, watchful, okay. Right, it is alert is like observant. Okay, then warrior, you know what is the warrior? Sultan the warrior. So what of warriors are there? So who is a warrior? Warrior is a soldier or a sailor or a pirate. It's not pirate Caribbean. He's not a spy. Not 7-0 is a spy. So who is a warrior? Is the answer is very easy. What is the answer? Ace. Exactly, right. It is easy, you know it, right? See, ipo nengku manasilando oru word aa meaning engenaanu namukku understand cheyandathu. Okay, next, ingane undavu cavalier treatment. Cavalier treatment. So appo you just divide this four, A, B, C, D. It is courteous, high handed or negligent or affectionate. So then A is the answer. A is the answer. Anyone answer? So is the meaning on, what is the meaning of a cavalier? Is a bad man or something like that it comes under. So what is the answer here? No answers. Anyone? No idea. See, negligent. Okay, okay, right. Okay, this is the way, right? Ippo nanku oru idea kittiyalle. So you got some idea, right? How to write it? Appo ee divide edittu understand cheyanam. So adinu before that you have to understand what does that word means. So adinu endayenu previous work. Nammal kore words സ്റ്റോറേജിൽ സേവ് ചെയ്യണം. സോ വാട്ട് യു വോണ്ട് ടു ഡു, പ്ലീസ് റീഡ് ദ ന്യൂസ് പേപ്പർ ഓർ റീഡ് സെയിം തിങ് ഫ്രോം ദി ഡിക്ഷണറി ഓർ ഫ്രം ലോട്ട് ഓഫ് ഏരിയസ്. ഈ മോസ്റ്റ് വേർഡ്സ് നമ്മൾ മാക്സിമം ഇൻപുട്ടിലേക്ക് കയറ്റുക. ഓക്കെ, ലാമെന്റ്. വാട്ട് ഇസ് മീനിങ് ഓഫ് എ ലാമെന്റ്? കംപ്ലൈൻ, കമെന്റ്, കണ്ടം, കൺസോൾ. ഈസ് ലാമെന്റിങ്, ലാമെന്റിങ് എന്ന് പറയും. വാട്ട് ഇസ് ദിസ് വൺ? Answer is yes, very good. It's condemn, it's condemn. C-O-N-D-O-N-E. Lament means condemn. Okay, reckless, reckless. courageous, rash, bold, daring, recklessness. ഈ വേർഡ് നമ്മൾ കേട്ടിട്ടുണ്ട് അല്ലേ, റെക്ലെസ്നെസ്. അപ്പൊ റെക്ലെസ്നെസ് ഇറ്റ്സ് എ കറേജ് ആണോ, റാഷ് ഓർ ബോൾഡ് ഓർ ഡാരിങ്? വാട്ട് ഇസ് ദ ആൻസർ ബെറ്റി? ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് എ. ഡി പ്രമോദ് ഇസ് ഗിവൻ ഡി. ജഷീര എ. സോ മാക്സിമം എ കംസ് റൈറ്റ്. ദാറ്റ്സ് ഓൾ. എനി അതർ ആൻസേഴ്സ്? റെക്ലെസ്, ഇറ്റ്സ് നോട്ട് റാഷ്. ഓ, Abhijit has given B. Next, always B. Ellarum pinne B aan. Okay, I'll tell you the answer. Answer is B. Yes, rash. Reckless drive. Rash drive. Right? Okay. No problem. If you got wrong answer, no tension, nothing. Just it is a practice. Okay. But ee pattern aanu namukku exam il verundavum. Appo ee pattern note cheythu namukku practice cheytha mathi. Okay, so now it is the opposite meaning to understand. Flagiteers. Flagiteers means criminal. What is the opposite? Criminal, what is the opposite? You know the answer, right? I hope you got the answer. Yes, yes. Appo flagiteers na endanu arayanam. Ingena korchu tough aayittulla word meaning undavum. Adinte meaning arna namukku opposite arayam. Appo you have to be very strong with the meaning. Now it is innocent, you know. Okay, sometime the questions will be like this. Ipoma, you have seen here, one single word was there. Sometimes it will be like a word like this. Pursuit, teenager was warned that he would be expelled from school if he did not take a haircut and pay attention to his grooming. Nanku idilu ulla clue arnyo. Did you understand the clue here? This is a sentence that Hirsute, teenager, was warned that he would be expelled from school if he did not take a haircut and pay attention to his grooming. Appa hirsute nu varuna endana? Quiet aano varuthilla. Erudite or bald or scaly. Appa idinte opposite aanu namukku vendathu. Idu question il idanamma. What is this opposite? What is the answer you are giving me? C is the answer. Archana, Jasir are very actively there. Naveen, then Sarangi. C. Betty said B. Okay, now the answer check. Yeah? The answer is Kali. Hirsute na full mudiyala than. It is a it is B. Bald head. Bald. Yes, B is the answer. Okay, then this is another type of your questions. See here in your this questions below, you have four alternatives. See, I said na, all the answers in your question paper, it will be in your question paper. You want to just choose the best one. So what do you want? A little bit preparation will give you a great results, right? Little bit understanding of your strongness, it will sure help you to pass this paper with an excellent mark, right? So how easy is it, right? It is easy now to understand, right? Okay, now this is another portion. Right, in this question, what do you want to do is you want to substitute the given word or sentence. So where you can do this one, you can take it from. This is a one word substitution. You all have at least for till examination, if you have a by newspaper or old newspaper, it's old no enough. You have to improve your reading vocabulary. At least Indian Express, any one English paper with low cost you can buy or you can borrow from your neighbor. Sit, read, and you will get the practice. So you can attend online test also, mock test. You can work out the previous year question papers. Anything you can do by this area. Appo ee area la the next part, what is the trick you have to follow? What is the strategy? This is a three way. You can improve it. You can improve your vocabulary list. Now, one who possesses many talents. Nammal avar endu parayum? See, this is a one substitute word aanu. Appo oru sentence la നമുക്ക് ആൻസേഴ്സ് താഴെ ഉണ്ട്. വൺ ഹു പൊസസ് മെനി ടാലൻസ്, അവരെന്ത് പറയും? വെർസറ്റൈൽ, മൊബൈൽ, എക്സെപ്ഷണൽ, ഗിഫ്റ്റഡ്. So what we say? Betty said A, maximum A, S. Is a versatile person. Yes, right. Did you understand? Earlier and there, no, it's a one word you have to understand. But here one sentence that you have to write the answer. Yes, very good. Next one. A person who knows many foreign languages. What we say? Linguistic. Grammarian, polyglot, bilingual. Bilingual. Bilingual is knowing that two languages is a bilingual. So what is the answer here? Yeah. So you're all very good in English, right? Very good. Very good. Yes, that is the answer. While it's a linguistic, the person who knows a very lot of foreign languages. Okay. Here, one who eats everything. We can see that person. Right? So what type of person we say? Yes, we know it. It's not omniscient, irresistible, insolvent. Yes, fibbing. Very good. Yeah, you're all very studious. Your people are very fast. Very good. Happy to see that one in the morning. Okay, he's a omnivorous, right? Omnivorous. Okay. Okay. Study of the evolution of man as an animal. This is a study of the evolution. So of man as an animal. Animal in the manishan vandu nu parayunnathu archaeology aanu, anthropology, anthropology or chronology or ethnology. Yes. Devika, it is D or B, Devika? All are B. Devika, it's D. Okay. Vandum kodi alaikya. It's study from the evolution of animal from man. What is this study we says? Archaeology, it's a different, right? Chronology is different. It is anthropology. It's study of animal from human is about anthropology. Okay, yes. Okay. Ipo, the next question paper pattern, what do you have is like it to be a proverb or an idiom. See, nangla like exam pattern is so good, but you don't get scared when you are starting it of any portions. It's all you studied and you know it very well, but you have to practice it, okay, according to the new concepts idea. That's all. So now this is the next portion, correct meaning of the proverbs or idioms. Sometimes idioms will be there, proverbs will be there. Appo you know what is an idiom? Idiom is a combination of word. It will be differently figurative. It is different figurative meaning than the literal meaning of each word and phrases. Okay, adana idioms. So I'll tell you the examples. And proverb, you know, it is a short while and a tooth of peace advice based on a common sense or an experience. So idu rendu no namaku answers find out ayya aadyam. Ipo idioms, idioms or phrases, how we are going to do it off. First, what do you want to, the tip one is, do not limit yourself to a meaning alone. Don't go into a direct meaning. Idioms vartha vera. So the first tip is, do not limit yourself. So try to understand the particular context and the phrase has been used. So this will help you to understand and remember the particular idiom or phrases better. This is the first, do not limit yourself. So don't make it a justification. This is what. No, just go through the full thing and understand what it exactly mentioned. What is the figurative it comes around? Then keep a handy list for revising what you have learned. So just have a handy notes, note it down whatever you have done, write it, whatever you're learning it day by day. Just make it into a note of it. Then do not try to cram at once. Right? Never try and learn too many idioms or phrases at the same time. So you will be like strucking up. You will be like you never learning it. Make into a grouping. Grouping and team into quiet for a good idea. So make it into groups daily basis and don't go with the common idioms and phrases. Go with an sequences and do like don't continuously go on it. Then it will be you can't remember or you can't store it in the database. So database, in a proper way, we have to store it off. Then relate in the idiom way phrases to visionary imaginary. See, idioms if you learn, make it into a visual picture. So it is easy to store it. Right? By keeping a word and thing, it's better to keep a visionary of it, and it is easy to link with them. And so it never forget them, right? So it will never forget them. So when we when you remember some movie name, you won't remember as movie name. We will forget the movie name. What we'll say, see, these are the sequence, this is will happen, this the hero and heroine, that particular song will be there in that movie. It was very famous. So, right, even though, ippadum namukku angane oru orma undaavum, namukku chalappo peru pettanu kittathilla, but aa scene o adile ulla actor o actress o oru particular or important sequence namukku orma undaavum. Appo endha avunna baaki ulla sambhavam namukku easy aayittu catch cheyan pettathullu, right? So what we can do is sequence, so try to relate them with the picture, so sure it will be remain trained there, and it will help you at the time of writing it in the paper. Then try to understand the origin, where it is, what story, where it started, and what is the real meaning, and where you get exercise this lesson sometimes. So it also help you for passing this, and it will help you to pass this idiom and phrases. Okay, so this is certain tips I'm telling you, certain strategies to follow by while you are preparing for your idiom and phrases. Okay, for example, a piece of cake. Nammal endu vicharikkum? Oru cake ide oru piece. No. So idiom says, unclogging my sink was a piece of cake for Cutler. She's a plumber. Meaning, extremely easy and straightforward. Right? It is a piece of cake. Alle? Do you understand? Appo namukku ee tips back nokkiya. Don't limit yourself to meaning alone. Understand the context. Endana a piece of cake, immediately we'll say it's a piece of cake, it's a piece of pizza. We'll think no, the real meaning of it is extremely easy and straightforward. So sometimes when you ask for to work off it, we'll say it is a piece of cake, in the sense I'm very extremely easy and straightforward to do it, no issues. It is what we are saying, a piece of cake. Let the cat out of the bag. Nammal endu vicharikkum? Poochena pidiche kavarda porthaakku? No, we shouldn't directly translate this one. So in this sentence, endana, I'm planning a surprise holiday for Lamb to celebrate our wedding anniversary. Don't let the cat out of the bag. That is, reveal a secret by mistake. Okay, nammal parayilla cat is on the wall. Nammal endu vicharikkum? Poocha wall nadakkano? No, in the sense we don't know. I'm not in situation to take any decision. That is, the cat is on the wall. Namukku athrayum valiya sentence parayanda, namukku endu parayam? Cat is on the wall. So let the cat out of the bag. Idu poochine pidiche porthina bagilo agathina bag idanna sambhavalla. Don't let the cat out of the bag. It says don't reveal a secret by mistake. Appo nammal oru party friend innu plan cheyunu, vicharunna don't reveal the secret by mistake. See, when you are talking like this, when you are saying something to the people like, hey, don't reveal us a secret by mistakes, adinu pagaram let the cat out of the bag. Okay, see, adana ee sentence, don't let the cat out of the bag ennacha secret namakku kalayan padilla. Idakkeyanu nammala ee idioms la. Then judge a book, don't judge a book by its cover. Alle namakku kore messages varum, kore short videos ഒക്കെ നമ്മൾ കണ്ടിട്ടുണ്ടാവും. Don't judge a person based on its appearance. That is means the cover. So നമ്മൾ ഒരു ബുക്കിന്റെ കവറോ അത് കവർ ചെയ്തിരിക്കുന്ന വെച്ചല്ല പറയുന്നത്. ഇറ്റ് സേസ് അബൌട്ട്. Now you understand, right? What is this idiom? അല്ലേ മനസ്സിലാകുന്നുണ്ട് അല്ലേ? ഇപ്പൊ ഈ എക്സാമ്പിൾ കാണുമ്പോ, ഐ കുഡ് ഈറ്റ് എ ഹോഴ്സ്. അയ്യോ ഇതെന്താണ് ഐ കുഡ് ഈറ്റ് എ ഹോഴ്സ്? നോ, ഇറ്റ് സേസ് ലൈക്ക് ഐ എം സോ ഗ്ലാഡ് ഐ ഓർഡർഡ് ആൻ എക്സ്ട്രാ ലാർജ് പിസ്സ. ഐ കുഡ് ഈറ്റ് എ ഹോഴ്സ്. That is, I feel extremely hungry. Okay, so ingenta sentence aanu. Appo what will get? I could eat a horse. In below you will have lot of sentence. Which one is the right opt one? You have to write. Now beat around the bush. Usually our teacher say don't beat around the bush, come to the point. It says why to talking unrelevant subject, come to the point. അതാണ് ഡോണ്ട് ബീറ്റ് അറൗണ്ട് ദി ബുഷ് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ നമ്മൾ പോയി വീട്ടിൽ അവിടുത്തെ ഉള്ള ബുഷ് കുച്ചുകൊണ്ട് തട്ടണോ ചെയ്യണോ അല്ല ഇറ്റ് സേസ് അബൌട്ട് യു ഹാവ് ടു ബി ഡോണ്ട് ലിമിറ്റ് യുവർ അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡിങ് ബൈ എ ഷോർട്ട് വേ യു ഹാവ് ടു ഓപ്പൺ ഇറ്റ് ദൻ വൺസ് ഇൻ എ ബ്ലൂ മൂൺ ഇപ്പൊ റെഡ് മൂൺ ടി വിയിൽ പറയും റെഡ് മൂൺ വരുന്നുണ്ട് ഇറ്റ്സ് എ ബിഗ് റെഡ് മൂൺ ഇറ്റ്സ് എ ബ്ലൂ മൂൺ വാട്ട് ഇസ് ദിസ് ബ്ലൂ മൂൺ ബ്ലൂ മൂൺ ഇസ് വെരി റെയർലി ഓൺലി കുക്സ് അറ്റ് ഹോം വൺസ് ഇൻ എ ബ്ലൂ മൂൺ എപ്പോഴെങ്കിലും വല്ലപ്പോഴും വരുന്നുണ്ട് വെരി റെയർലി ഹി കംസ് അതാണ് വൺസ് ഇൻ എ ബ്ലൂ മൂൺ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ അവിടുത്തെ ബ്ലൂ മൂൺ അല്ല ഇറ്റ്സ് വാട്ട് സേസ് ഓക്കെ Understand? Then have butterflies in your stomach. We say, I have a butterflies in my stomach. Usually, if you watch Hollywood movies, they say, it's a lot of butterflies in my stomach. You know, I feel butterflies are in my stomach. So it's not like I would have butterflies in the sense I was very excited and nervous. Okay, Adana, it says about it. Okay, now coming to the testing point. You just give me the answer. To have an axe to grind. Nammal nere answer edukkan paadilla. It is the rule one. So what is this answer? A private end to serve, to failure to arouse interest, to have no result, to work for both sides, none of these. I need answers. Pramod, it's B. Jasir, it's E. Betty, you are so much fast to take decisions. Nanna aloiki nan what I said, what the tips I have given. To have an axe to grind, what does it means about? It's B from Atul, to have no results. Okay, athrayulla answers kaniyo. It's from Betty, is B, okay. Tarangi, D, none of these. So you have an idea, na? None of these vanna adanne irikkuna. Archana, okay. To have an axe to grind. Okay, shall I go to the answer? So the answer... See, so what do you understand? To have an axe to grind. What is this meaning of it? You have a private reason for doing it. You have a private reason for doing it. That is the answer. So which is mixed with this one? To have an axe to grind. You have your own axe to do something. Grind is to serve. Upper answer is A, a private end to serve. A private end to serve. To have an axe to grind in Varanya, its idea says about you have something do by your own or you are being involved in something. That is the meaning of it. Okay. It's okay. No tension or no worry about it. You can enhance of experience you will get. So first you understand like you have an axe to grind. So ingantha kore proverbs namla like padikanam. Kore... in something like idioms nammal understand to end in smoke to make completely understand to ruin oneself to excite great applause to overcome someone none of these it is easy to end in smoke and the meaning arnu what is the meaning okay very good okay ipo manasilayo to end in smoke appo to overcome someone alla end in smoke in the sense if you ruin yourself If to ruin yourself, to ruin oneself is the answer, to end in smoke. Okay, very good. You are learning it. Very good. Next one, to pickle holes, to pick holes. So to find someone reason to quarrel, to destroy something, to criticize someone, to cut some part of an item, none of these. To pick holes. So to pick holes, what we can do? Yes, okay. So you are knowingly doing it, right? You can understand, right? Okay. So for your understanding, it is a practice. Okay. Okay. Next is proverbs. So now you understand like these things. Then the proverbs you want to learn something of Indian proverbs, Asian proverbs are there. You have to learn it. You have to understand it. See, here some of the proverbs are here. A roaring lion kills nothing. A roaring lion kills nothing. What is the meaning of it? You don't accomplish your goal by talking about them. Simply, you say, no, the talking bird seldom bites. Right? So it is a proverb. So basically, you won't understand the proverbs. Right? So here I have given some of the proverbs to understand. Just go through this proverbs here. So next one you can see, a tree is known by its fruits. A tree is known by its fruits. A successful is shown by the deeds. Okay, so you know it. What is the, see, these are all like I have given lot of things are there to understand. The fat buffalo will attract the lean buffalo. That is, successful people lead by examples. It's not talking about the buffalo. So here what you want to do is you have to practice with some of the proverbs. Don't call a dog with wipe in your hand. Meaning is, people does not, don't listen to an aggressive leader. Okay, but it's not been directly comparing. It is a proverb. So which are the proverbs are there? We have to understand. Okay, then the old horse is a stable, still yearns to run. Those who are older still have things they would like to accomplish. He who answers is inferior to the one who asks the question. Okay, nammle chodyam choikkunna munpu nammle adine pettiyulla knowledge aayirikkana anganeyan. It is better to be curious than knowledgeable. Dig the well before you are thirsty. Dig the well before you are thirsty. Anticipate your needs before you need something. Anticipate your needs before you need something. Complaining is the weak man's weapon. Complaining. So strong people, what they say, they will solve problem instead of complaining about them. Strong people. So this about this proverb says about complaining is weak of a man's weapon. Okay. So these are all certain proverb examples. Now, a leopard can't change its dress. So just note down the question answers. In end, we will discuss about it. A leopard can't change its tail. It's a proverb. It's not a meaning. Tail stripes spots nature. I told, don't directly go into the meaning. It is a proverb, not the answer. One, what is the answer? A, B, or C, D. A leopard can't change its, which one? Spots, nature, strips, or tail. Okay, you just mark the answer. Nangla mark note edu vecha madi. Okay, D, if you note it down D, keep it in a notebook mark. Last one, okay, answer reveal ayam. Second one, every cloud has a silver color, hue, lining, finish. Color, hue, lining, finish. So every cloud has a silver endana. It is a proverb. Ingane nanku exam il undavum. Next, one man's dash is another's poison. One man's food, medicine, meat, drink. Don't think directly. It is a proverb. One man's is dash another's poison. Third one. I'll move to the next one. I hope you have a note down the answers, right? Yes, ma'am. Yes, Navi. You mark the answers, and last we will discuss the answers. Okay. This is a proverb. it has given in a fill in the blank style. This also can given in a fill in the blank style. Okay, fine. Okay, familiarity does content, makes, breeds, generates, produces. Familiarity makes or breeds or generates or produces. Think before you. Think before you. It's a very famous proverb, you know. It is all for your practice and just cross-checking your skills, your talents. Okay. And through this, you will raise your, increase your confidence. Leap, jump, run. Okay, sorry, there is an connection problem. Can you hear me? Can you hear me, ma'am? Okay, thank you. So where we are, we can okay. So this is what na ivide irunna le. Okay, last one, paddle your own boat, yacht, canoe, rift. Which is the answer? So we will go to the answer page. Just check your answer and give me the scores. Okay, about 10. First one is sports. The leopard answer, lining, meat, breeds, leap, mouth, throw, cake, do, canoe. This is the answer. Check with your answers. I'll give you 1 minute to check your answer. We'll move to the next session. How many of you got what marks? in this session. What is your marks? Spots, leopard answer spots, lining, meat, breeds, leap, mouth, throw, cake, do, canoe. You just make a cross check. What is your score send on? Got the score, ma? Out of 10. No, I didn't got the scores. Okay. Oh, you didn't get some questions also, right? Okay. Okay, this is the don't look at the answers we have need. This is the sixth question. Don't look at gift horse in the face, head, tummy, mouth. People in glass house should not dash stones. They should not. You can't hear your dash and it to eat it too. You can't have your dash. Pudding, cake. You don't have your pudding or cake or meat or ice cream. Okay, then ninth one, when in Rome, dash as Romans do. Paddle your own. This one. Canoe. When you in Rome, do as Romans do. Okay, so you got the answers. If you got the answers, then good. Then we'll move to the next session. Answer kittiyo, marks kittiyo. Okay, make a cross check. Are you there, guys? Can you hear me? Okay, ma. Okay, fine. Okay. Okay, the next session. Can we move to the next session? Marks arnillalo. Okay, you do your own marks and just identify what it is. Okay, then we have another session. These are all very easy areas. And the another thing is like identify the para jumbled questions. So in this portion, the questions are been jumbled. You have to identify which is the right one and sequence answer. Easy, I said no. Answers are always there. You have to check it and you have to write it properly. Okay, so how you can identify it? Put a paragraph on. See, in starting I told you you have taken lot of time to read this area, so I'll given here some of the tricks how to make it out. So identify the open sentence. First thing, you have to identify the open sentence of the paragraph. So what it really says about, or what it is the lesson, or what its sentence is in its position, and generally what it introduce about the topic. Okay, you don't worry the paragraph of things to worry about it. It's like a paragraph of a sentence will be there. Identify the first open sentence. It starts with what, and next one is identify the closing sentence. Right, this is the first two thing will be there. What is the open sentence and what is the closing sentence? And the second one, like how, what is the paragraph is possibly closing or ending with, or what type of actual logic was involving. Okay, and what is the continuation of the same, we have to identify. So first, when you are reading a paragraph, read the open sentence and the close sentence, then identify the mandatory pairs. Okay, a mandatory pairs about to solve the jumbles. What is the sequence? What is the basically grouping to define the order? So there is sure. So appo endana, it means sure there is a pairing of mandatory things will be available one after another, or 1 2 3 4 likewise. First comes, second comes, third comes. By reading the each options, we can understand some mandatory options are there to solve the answers. And next one, identifying the transition of words. Okay, so when you, there is a logical connection of the sentences, or it will be lead to be correct the mandatory pair. I said na, or sequences in doubt, there is an activities or a sequences, a logical links between the between every sentence. So a transaction word endano, you have to correct it. The transaction word that you have to correct it, you have to understand it. So it will something like some commonly using used transition words in Nokia, again, furthermore, in addition, likewise, it's all for one thing, for above all, certain things. I have given some examples for your reading purpose. Then identify pronoun antecedents. So this antecedents you can understand like what it really pronouns to use it. He, she, it, him, with whom. So what is the personal pronouns? So with what, it's a place or a thing, what it refers. And so through this one, we can simply understand the sentence, what it really applying or implying with the previous statement. So it is a namukapo 5 important points on starting, ending, third one, mandatory pairs, then transition words and pronouns, what it really implying it. If you understand this 5 thing, you can get a easy to learn the paragraph. Okay, so this is what your questions, this is what your thing in be in your question paper. Each questions, there is a sentence of which some part of being jumbled up. Rearrange the parts which are labeled P, Q or S to produce the correct sentence. Choose the proper sequence. Very easy. Appa namakku 5 points ariyam. Through this one, we are going to work it out. Nengle tips note idalle. Okay. Ippa namakku, we'll go to the questions. Okay. So this is the formula format for you to have the answers. So you can read it off. There have been many stories of porpoises saving human lives. S6, this is the end statement. Marine scientists point out that the porpoise's spirit to play is responsible for such incidents. Appa PQRS dividend, it is a mingled of thing. So what you have to do, you have to understand like the aspects how we are going to do it. So just go through, read it off. இப்ப நம்ம பார்த்த இ 5 பாயிண்ட்ஸ் ரைட் திஸ் 5 பாயிண்ட்ஸ் ஐடென்டிஃபை தி ஓபனிங் சென்டென்ஸ் ஐடென்டிஃபை தி க்ளோசிங் சென்டென்ஸ் ஐடென்டிஃபை மாண்டேட்டரி பேர்ஸ் என்றான ஐடென்டிஃபை தி ட்ரான்சிஷன் வேர்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் ஐடென்டிஃபை தி இம்ப்ளை சென்டென்ஸ் தட் இஸ் தி பர்சனல் ப்ரோனவுன் பர்சனல் ப்ரோனவுன்ஸ் அண்ட் வாட் இஸ் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் வித் தி பேர்ஸ் சோ ஹியர் யூ கேன் சே தி யூ கேன் ஹியர் யூ கேன் see all these things ரைட் So P is when I got to my feet, no one was near, but it was. So first one, there have been many stories of porpoises saving human lives. Apo marine scientists point out the porpoise's spirit of playing in responsible for such incidents. Apo something happened. A man standing nearby said that porpoises have showed me ashore. I felt something give me a terrific show up to upon the beach seashells. One woman was wading waist deep off the Florida coast. Coast when an undertow pulled her down. When I got my feet, no one was near. But see, if 5 tips points namakku, what is the starting, what is the ending? Appa many stories to say about the human lives in the middle of an ocean, it happened. So something is happened. What it happened? It starts with. Okay, so the answer is Q or PS. Q. See, here you can see. Ippa namukku shraddhicha ariyam. There have been many. This is what started saving human lives. Appo one woman was wading waist deep on the Florida coast when an undertow pulled her down. Then what happened? I felt something give me a terrific show up on the beach, she says. Then third, when I got on my feet, no one was near. But I was in the water about 80 feet out of the porpoises was sleeping out. Then a man was standing nearby said that the porpoises have showed me ashore. Appo he was saying about the sentence. Okay, appo answer was here. There is a one sequence, one chain of activities, one chain of link was there. So here in the below you have the 4 answers. PRSQ, QPRS. So you have to find this answer by the 5 tips. 5 points I have quoted. Okay, then this is one example. Okay, then another thing one is here. The bus stop. This is the first starting point. And this, then his eyes rested with cold malaise on the dog. In between, we have these four topics, four things, the happenings are here. They took their seats. The young woman was carrying a pet dog. A woman and a man got in together. The conductor came in and took the fares. So the bus stop, already the bus stop. Bus stop, then what happened? The conductor came in and took the fares. Or a woman and the man got in together, got in. Upon the bus stop. Then the sequence is a woman and a man got in together. Then what happened? They took their seats. Seatilu poi irunnu. Then what happened? The young man was carrying a pet dog. Right. Then last one. The conductor came in and took the fares. And last one. The last sentence, then his eye rested with cold malaise on the dog. Cold malaise on the dog. So, ingeniana, a paragraph, it is jumbled. Up and there, no buses, a woman and got into it together. Basilicari, our irunu, conductor Faruangi, our lady in the Kailo, a pet on diarno. Then last one is about the conductor came into took fares our kailo undan. So this is a sequence. So in this sequence, how we are going to managing it? Sometime it can be a word or sentence. Okay. Then another one, James Watt used the power of steam to drive machines. The jet engine is relatively more recent. Okay. Or a starting line, James Watt used to power of steam to drive machines. Last in the ermo. The jet engine is relatively more recent. So between words, you can see the trick starting, ending, what is the transiting word, what is the personal noun, and what is the closure of relatively with. With the petrol engine, people were able to build motor cars and aeroplane. Yes. Then many years later, the petrol engine was invented. These provide quicker means of traveling. Yes. Key invention was used later by other clever men to give us the railway engine. Upper James was used the power of steam to drive machines. This is the starting. So his invention was used later by other clever men to give us the railway engine. Then where it goes to Q. Then many years later the petrol engine was invented. And then invented people with the petrol engine, people were able to build motor cars and aeroplanes. Adonde endayi, these provide quicker means of traveling. Namukku vegam travel cheyanulla information. So each individual sentences are very clear in this paragraph. You have a starting and an ending. In between, you have to arrange the jumble. This is a para jumbled and para sentenced things. Okay. Now the next part is, you already studied the direct speech and indirect speech. Indirect speech, how it has been, in what way it is parting in your exam point of view. So you know direct speech is repeating the exact word spoken, and indirect speech is known as the reporting the words. So here are some examples of it's a models. See, in usually in the direct and indirect speech, we have different models are there. One is with model, verb, pronoun, certain things are there. I just explained, and I have given the ideas, and you have to, because it's a long gap. Now you have seen this one. You can, if in a direct speech, it can, could, may, might, you know, should, might, could, would, or out to. This is a models of models, factors like models. So here is the example of this model. He said, I can cook food. He said that he could cook food. Direct and indirect speech in the models. It's a model thing. They said we may go to Canada. This is a question. They said that they might go to Canada. She said, I must finish the work on time. So she said that she had to finish the work on time. So Kanika said, I out to avoid junk foods. Kanika said that she out. Certain thing we can add it, right? Shout, might, could, would. Then we have to do it. But for your example, by reporting verb, Navin said he is ang. Navin said that he was ang. Reporting a verb when you're reporting it. Isha says, I am pretty. Isha says that she is pretty. Rohan will say, I am tall. Rohan will say that he is tall. They said, the sun rises in the east. They said that the sun rises in the east. This is about reporting verb. Next is using the tense. We have present tense, past tense and future tense, and lot of tenses are there. So Hina said, I walk. Hina said that she walked. Deepak said, I am having tea. Deepak said that he was having tea. Aisha said, honey was left for school. Aisha said that honey had left for school. So Vidisha says, Anaya took pasta. Vidisha says that Anaya had taken pasta. They told we are living in Paris. They told that they have been living. They have been living in Paris. Ramesh said, I will go to Sri Lanka. Go to. So he would go to Sri Lanka. So interrogative sentence. So about the examples of the direct and indirect speech. So you have to understand whether it is which one it comes around. Ravi said, what is Hina doing? Ravi asked me what Hina was doing. Okay. It is a interrogative sentence. Here Ravi asked me what Hina was doing. Isha said, will she come for lunch? Isha asked if she would come for lunch. The boy asked, where do you stay? The boy inquired, where I stayed. Okay, then it is about the pronoun. Vidya said, I'm a good girl. Vidya said that she was a good girl. I told them, you have finished your work. I told them that they had finished their work. He said, she's in Delhi. He said that she was in Delhi. See, avala ennodu parayumbo, she's in Delhi, she said to me. But what I have to tell, he said that she was in Delhi. Okay, so I said to Nandini, please help me with my homework. When a question comes like this, you have to change into, they will give you this into a paragraph endana. Adu endu change cheyanonu, it will be clearly given in your question paper. Don't worry. One is some things they'll ask you to go for indirect. Sometimes they'll ask you to go for direct speech. So it is said to Nandi, please help me with my homework. I requested Nandini. So it's a four option. I request Nandini to help me with my homework. I requested Nandini to help me in homework. Nandini requested me to help her with their homework. So this transfers this into, I requested Nandini to help me with my homework. Direct speech. Kanna said to his wife, please select one of those saris. Kanna pleased his wife to select one of those saris. Requested his wife to please select one of the saris. Kanna told his wife to please select one of those saris. So please select one of the saris. So Kanna told his wife to please select one of the saris is the answer. Okay, Ravi said to the judge, I did not commit this crime. For judge in order, Ravi Parna, I didn't commit this crime. So it is into your speech. Ravi said the judge that he had not committed the crime. No, I did not committed the crime. Ravi said to the judge that he did not committed the crime. Ravi said to the judge that he had not committed that crime. Ravi said to the judge that he had not committed this crime. Apo, the answer is, Ravi said to the judge that he had not committed that crime. Okay, so he said, I will do it now or never. The four options are there. He said that he would do it then or never. He said that he will now or never do it. He said that he will do it now or never. He said that he would now or never do it. The answer is option A. He said that he would do it then or never. Okay, so in your paragraph, jumbled words, and in each paragraph, and sometimes I said, no, some of the questions will come in the fill in the blanks. And so this is the type of, we have around 8 to 9 type of things we have discussed about the above sentence. What you can do is simply, as I said, you have to have a practice. And in online, and you have books are there to practice. And in like reading, your newspaper gives you lot of when your competitive exams for your current affairs, general knowledge, current affairs, everything newspaper gives you a better reading habits, and how their vocabulary, how their phrases they framed, how they are being used the words, you can understand, right? Hindu newspaper or Indian Express or any newspapers that you have read, you can understand about the concepts. So English is very beautiful language, and you can easily can come over, you can easily pass it off. But I said before that, which is your strong area, which way? See, I said now you 40 are here, you all have an individual you all have an individual talents, right? Individual power of understanding, individual power of storing your databases. So what you have to do is, please, which is your easy way to take it off? So here what I have given, this is the way, ma, this is the universal way that you can easily go through the papers, or you can easily understand it. So I said your practice want to make you perfection. So I just completed here. So if you have any doubt, you can talk to me in my group. You can ask me any doubts or anything else, you can please talk to me. I'll help you. So we will discuss about the various 5-6 years of question papers. So this is the system. If you see the question paper now, sometimes usually the paragraph you'll come for 5 marks, sometime it for 10 marks. That's what I want to tell you. So don't bother, don't worry. This is the common criteria. But I have given like a sample here. So rest of the things, you have to work it out. You have to learn it out. So easily for 50, you can get good marks by here. If you feel which area is your good. Somebody says, ma'am, I'm good in logical area. Or somebody says, ma'am, I'm good in QT. Yes, score it off. So that area, first you can focus. Okay, so see, Nyananda Paranavarna, you have 4 sessions. Somebody says, ma'am, I'm good in QT, solving it. Yes, go start with the QT. If somebody says, ma'am, I'm good in current affairs and GK, I was like that. Okay, at least start with that. Somebody can say, ma'am, I'm good in logical reasoning. Okay, you start from there. Apo, which is your strong area? You start from there. What will happen now? When you start answering it, sometimes we solve it. Previous, namukku arayna answer aayirikkum, we can 100% assure that answer is right, what you are doing. Appo, what will happen, it really gives you confidence, right? Then your energy will be increasing and your confidence level will increase. So automatically, you are getting more energy. So try to grab more energy for the known area. So this is the best way, right? The strategy you can follow. Identify your strong areas and you can pitch it off first and you can start scoring. You are gaining, you are gaining your energy time and you are saving time. Then remaining that time, you can give it to other portions. Other area, ippo namukku athra ariyatha oru side varumbo adu concentrate cheyyam. Pinne one thing you can assure about your marks, sure you are passing with that marks, adu namukku assure cheyyan pattum. Aa oru confusion namukku avoid cheyyan pattum. Okay, aa confusion namukku avoid cheyyan pattum. So my advice is, don't mix match together, have a strategy, understand your own strategy and skills, understand your skill is important. Then practice it. Then practice it by reading newspaper, by reading dictionaries, by doing workouts in online or offline, by using anything like magazines or anything. You just grab it off, do the crosswords puzzles. So there you will be very familiar, at least for next till exam, familiar with this one. This is the way of preparing yourself for the entrance, any type of entrance. And moreover, you're writing for an MBA. MBA is all about doing and not a different thing, doing the same thing in a different way. See, previously you have prepared for a lot of exams, but when you're preparing these exams, you should be have a very planned way. That is what all about an MBA aspirants will do. So I wish you all the best and success for you people, and crack the exam. rock your exam. That's what I want to say about that. So I thank you for your patient listening, and you are very actively participated. That's some very heartwarming here. So your lot, thank you so much. So if you have any questions, you can talk, ask me or anything else.
Now I request the participant students, please raise your queries. She has covered all the areas for your exam purpose. So it is a time of query clarification. Don't hesitate. If you feel any query, you can raise.
Or you can type also, I'll answer you if you have hesitation to talk.
Sangeeta, please verify the chat box if any queries is raised.
When we can expect a KMAT exam, sir?
Normally, first week of August. Normally, we expect that it will be by first week of August 2021. Verify the chat box. Sometimes certain students are very reluctant in asking questions. May include questions in the chat box.
Yes, sir. Sir, you can ask me, ma'am, I am having this challenge, how I can prepare. Also, you can talk to me. Please utilize this hours, because we are exclusively sparing time for this, you people. PDF of this session, I'll give you. Yeah, I will send you. No issues about it. I'll send you. Then I'll give you some of the practicing thing also, like idiom phrases, proverbs and all. I'll send you. Sure, we'll provide you, Harsha. Website also, we have old question papers, ma. Not in our website. Website won't have any old question papers. We will have to collect the question papers. So sure, we will give you these also. We will give you the question paper pattern also. One next sessions, if we have, we will discuss about that also. We will send you in our group. Whether the KMAT exam is KMAT exam, sir, whether the KMAT is on online mode. Yes, sir, online.
Normally, that government will decide. We don't have any idea about that. Normally, online. The situation, they usually... planning to conduct this through online only because of the current COVID pandemic situation. Depends on government decision. We cannot say.
Okay. So we will solve the questions and answers. We will tell you, ma, the answers. Somebody is asking me. So what is this you are asking, ma? Quant. Max, next so afternoon 2 to 4 you will have a quity session. Our expert will take you. Dr. Jagadishan sir will handle you the quity session. Max sessions will be there. So registration will be announced in the websites. Previous, see, from 2017 previous we have question papers. We will worked out and we will give you the answers also. Okay, we will discuss also in one day. Okay. For a quantitative aptitude, we have a session, ma. That's what Quant was asked. We have an exclusive session on tomorrow. Faculty is handling on Quant and GK also. Tomorrow we have sessions. Please don't miss any of the session. Okay.
QT is in the afternoon session. Quantitative aptitude in the afternoon session. Today afternoon.
Oh, today. Yes, sir. Today afternoon we have quantitative sessions. Okay. Yeah, sure, we will notify in our group. You are all in our group now. We will notify once the registration starts. Sure. We are all keeping an eye on you and we will update you. Sure. See, for all the other QT session, your GK session and the quant sessions will be handling. So for this today and tomorrow, we have fully engaged. Please attend all the session, ask questions, clear a doubt. And okay, so there is in the website, it will be sent in one. Our admin has posted you guys. So floor is open. You have any other doubts, please you can ask. Just start preparing it. Don't wait to get dates. Date varte pinnu nokkangane cheyanda. Because already time has given from government and the university. So please parayna ellam kodi daily oru time odukittu you have to prepare. Prepare idu vekka. Then it is easy for to revise on the final day of the examination. Don't confuse yourself. Have a clear plan. That's what I want to tell. Right, whatever the exam you are writing, na, have a clear idea which is your strong area, which is your topmost. If we have four sessions, which is one, number one, you have been very well, good. And namku preparation venda, that you keep first. Second one, it's okay, 75%, I'm okay. Next is 50%, I'm this and that, anginevula subject. Then last one is, I was very poor in considering area, you can keep it in the fourth. So you, accordingly, you can... prepare and keep like referring old year question papers and attending this one. It's really help you. And if you need, you can talk to me individually. I'll give you supports, everything. No issues. We are there to help you for any type of questions. Okay. KMAT registration fees.
It will announce by the government. We don't have any idea.
Yes, Arya. So
it will be nominal only, not significant, but only a meager amount. Normally, they charge only meager amount, maybe 600 rupees. Sangeeta, please ask to clarify any query. Otherwise, you invite one candidate from the participants to propose the voter time, Sangeeta.
Okay, sir.
You invite one of the candidates.
Any volunteer there, you can give the vote of thanks here in our session. Any volunteer?
Otherwise, you just call anyone students.
Okay. So they are the future aspirants. So future managers, right? That's what you are going to write MBA. MBA is all about to be a professional. I need any volunteer or I'll call somebody else. Okay. Or like Naveen, can you give the vote of thanks here?
Can you hear me, ma'am?
Aye, Naveen. Yes, Naveen.
Can you hear me, ma'am? Yes, ma'am. The session was so nice.
Yeah, I can. We can.
Yes, I can able to develop myself.
Okay.
It is very helpful, ma'am. So I can prepare easily. Waiting for the next session, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you.
Remember the concepts forever.
So,
thank you, ma'am.
Aslam, can you give a... Okay, ma'am. Thank you, Naveen. So any other volunteer are there? Aslam, can you? Or Sharangi? Anyone, like, you have to speak, right? Or Devika?
Ma'am? Ma'am, can you hear me, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, bestie.
Ma'am, my name is...
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, we can.
I'm attending the class through my mother's phone, okay. So that's why my name is appearing as Betsy.
Oh, Betsy. Okay, nice. You are the fastest one to take answers, right? I watched.
Thank
it.
You, ma'am.
okay.
I mean, it was a beautiful session, and I'll thank you to the principals for arranging us this. Beautiful class or sessions for our KMAT coaching.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Nayantara. Anyone, please, your response is very important, because whenever we organize these type of programs in future also, we will consider any grievances on your part. That is why. Anyone.
Arya, can you? They are hesitating. Okay.
Anu Krishna. Please on your video, please speak. Anu Krishna. Sarangi Mohan.
Yes, sir.
Please on your video, please speak. How do you feel about the session?
Thank you, sir, for conducting such a session. Thank you, Sangeeta ma'am. It was really helpful. Now I get an idea about how to handle the English session, and I look forward to attending more sessions. And thank you for conducting such a free online class.
Nice.
Thank you, sir, and thank you, Sangeeta ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Varsha V. Menon, please, on your video.
Hi, sir. Varsha. It's a nice class, and thank you for conducting it's a wonderful class about this KMAT. I already attended IBS, one of the private entrance, but detailing is ma'am conducted very detailed. She has detail more about it. It's a nice class. Thank you, ma'am, for this.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Asha. Okay, any more clarification from your side? Otherwise, we will wind up. You can sign out and request you to join exactly by 1:45 itself, because our next session will commence by 2:00, exactly 2:00. Quantitative aptitude class will commence exactly 2:00. I request everyone to join by 1:45 itself. Okay, now right now you can sign out. Sangeeta?
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. Sure.
You can sign out. Okay. Sure.
Okay.
You can sign out, please.